And we are keeping a close eye on the weather. We got the snow and the cold in other parts of the country, but for us, it's just fog and maybe a little rain.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about, guys. You know, in fact, right now, we're talking about a major winter storm into New England. If you're heading up to the north, let's take a look at some video here. They're prepping for that as we speak. In fact, about a foot of snow is possible from parts of Massachusetts back toward Connecticut. Looks like a wintry mix coming up for New York. So not looking too good there. Let's take a look at the Viper Plus radar, because you'll see what we're talking about here as that rain turns to snow as it moves north and eastward. Storm tracker radar now back here at home, sweeping live. You'll see a couple of showers right off the Volusia coastline, trying to move right up to the north, northeast, northwest rather. So Volusia County, you may get one of those stray showers or sprinkles to come on shore today. Brevard County as well. That's the issue there today, with any of those showers being very brief, but looks like most of us stay dry. We're in the low 60s right now, 61 at the Villages, 55 at Ocala, 65 at Melbourne, and 59 at Daytona Beach. Visibility issues, definitely. Kissimmee, Sanford, Leesburg, the Villages, Ocala. In fact, we have our dense fog advisory, the northern and western areas again this morning. So you want to allow a little extra time, slow down, use those low beams for sure, because the dense fog reducing visibility is way below a quarter of a mile even at times. Satellite and radar picture, there it is, all clear. You can see those Atlantic showers out there starting to increase the moisture a bit in the coming days. That's the trend on into the weekend. But another warm day today, low 80s Orlando, Kissimmee about 83, 79 the high today at Daytona Beach, and right around 81 for Melbourne. Our normal high is about 73, so we're way above that. Now, here's what's left of Olga. It's now a depression, and Hurricane Center issued its last advisory, but the model's still turning this thing off to the north, and it's already made that turn. So it does look like some of the moisture from Olga will continue to lift northward and begin to be a part of our forecast here as early as tomorrow. Here's our frontal system. It's going to get kicked on through here eventually by Sunday, but until then, we're just kind of warm and a little bit humid out ahead of it, a little more fog tonight, stray shower at the coast possible today. But look at that moisture increasing. The model really picking up on that now. So our southern areas tomorrow, a decent chance to see a little bit of rain coming on up from the south with this approaching front. It's not going to do much for us yet. So about a 20% chance tomorrow, but as Olga's moisture continues to work northwestward up toward South Florida, we'll get in on some of that, especially into Saturday in conjunction with the cold front that's rolling on through. So there's the low 80s right on through Friday. Saturday, I think, still a pretty warm day with increasing clouds and increasing rain chances through the day. The front swinging through on Saturday night, that's going to leave us with much cooler and drier weather on Sunday. Highs in the upper 60s, still hanging on to some morning rainfall. Look at that, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, high temps mid to upper 60s. Overnight lows mid-40s, and those humidity levels really dropping, so we can use this rain that's expected to arrive on Saturday big time, Kimberly, because we've been in a drought. You know, the fire season starting to kick on in here. We're probably going to have some fire concerns early next week.